My name is Michael Hanneman. I'm the captain of our department's Special Victims Bureau and Human Trafficking Task Force. And we're here today to talk with you about our recent operation, Operation Reclaim and Rebuild. Operation Reclaim and Rebuild is an annual coordinated statewide law enforcement effort designed to impact one of the most heinous crimes of modern times, the sexual exploitation of another human being for profit. This year's operation took place between Sunday, January 26th, and Saturday, February 1st. Here with us today are representatives from some of the 70 human trafficking teams, task forces, law enforcement agencies from throughout the state, which joined with the Los Angeles Regional Human Trafficking Task Force in this operation. Now I'd like to read some of their names and have them step forward so they can be recognized. Kay Buck from the Coalition of Slavery, Coalition to Abolish Slavery and Trafficking, also known as CAST. Wilbur Cantania, the group supervisor from Homeland Security Investigations. Stephanie Powell, executive director of Journey Out. Assistant Regional Administrator Emilio Mendoza from the Los Angeles County Department of Children and Family Services. Deputy District Attorney Guillermo Stantiso, from Human Trafficking Coordinator from the Los Angeles County District Attorney's Office.
Good morning.
Sheriff John McMahon from the San Bernardino County Sheriff's Department.
Good morning.
Lieutenant Ray Lara, San Gabriel Police Department.
Good morning.
The Western United States Regional Director, Dr. Jason Plunkett, Zoe International. Director Michelle Guyman from the Los Angeles County Probation Department. Human Trafficking Unit Supervisor, Deputy District Attorney Dana Fikowski, Contra Costa County District Attorney's Office.
Morning.
Sergeant Carl Cruz, Concord Police Department.
Good morning.
Lieutenant Kelly Moore, California Highway Patrol.
Good morning.
Deputy Chief of Detectives Chris Pitcher from the Los Angeles Police Department. Task Force Commander Jeannie Franco from the California Department of Justice.
Good morning.
District Administrator Quincy Thacker from the California Department of Corrections. Acting Assistant Special Agent in Charge Adrian Franco from the FBI.
Good morning.
Lieutenant Willie Triplett from the Anaheim Police Department.
Good morning.
And lastly, Parole Agent Bernard Miller from CDCR. And at this time, I'd now like to introduce Sheriff Alex Villanueva.
Good morning. A week in January, in particular, this was January 26th to February 1st, the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department, the Los Angeles Police Department, and the Los Angeles Regional Human Trafficking Task Force, in coordination with human trafficking task forces throughout the state, law enforcement agencies, and victim services providers across the state, we focus to reclaim and rescue human trafficking victims and connect them with victim service providers. Our goal is to help them rebuild their lives. Law enforcement agencies from across the state joined us to send a message to pimps, to exploiters, and to buyers that it is unacceptable to buy another human being for sexual purposes. Now, working alongside law enforcement, we've had social workers, victim advocates, and victim service providers actively working to reach trafficking victims, rescue them from their captors, and put them in a path to a brighter future. Our 2020 operation yielded significant results. We had 76 adults who were rescued, 11 children were rescued, 27 suspected traffickers and exploiters were arrested, and 266 Johns were arrested. In total, 518 criminal arrests were made during the week-long operation. From throughout the state, agencies share dramatic stories of victim rescues and exploiters being arrested. I'd like to share one of those encounters to highlight the incredible work accomplished by the dedicated men and women who fight trafficking every day. This comes out of Santa Clara. The Santa Clara Human Trafficking Task Force conducted a rescue operation at a hotel in Sunnyvale, during which detectives communicated with a commercial sex worker and arranged a meeting with her. When a male adult arrived and dropped off the woman for the arranged date, both were detained. The woman explained that she was in fear of the suspect and wanted to return to her home in Oregon. Detectives learned there were two other women under the male's control. They recovered the other woman and learned all three had been trafficking in areas from Reno, Nevada, to the San Francisco Bay Area of California. Detectives also learned that all three women were addicted to heroin. It appeared the male targeted them because of their addiction, and he kept a large amount of Narcan on hand in case of an overdose. And this is the way which he used to control them. The man who had just been discharged off of parole for human trafficking was arrested again on felony human trafficking and pimping charges. The three women, who were all adults, were connected with advocates, and two of the three accepted services. This kind of shows you just the human nature and the difficulty sometimes when convincing people to leave the sex industry and find a brighter path, but we're providing the services to get the, make this happen. Now, the Human Trafficking Awareness Month is the month of January. Operation Reclaim and Rebuild was specifically timed for January, which is Human Trafficking Awareness Month. And we have a message to the traffickers. Don't do business in Los Angeles County or the state of California. We will find you and prosecute you to the fullest extent of the law. To the Johns, purchasing commercial sex is illegal and adds to exploitation of those involved. And to the victims, you're the focus of this endeavor. We're here for you. This operation is to help you reclaim your freedom from the binds of sex trafficking and to provide the support and tools to rebuild your lives. Now, we clearly recognize that without the expertise and commitment of our dedicated public and private service providers, the victims in these cases would face insurmountable challenges in reclaiming and rebuilding their lives. I'd like to introduce Kay Buck, the CEO and Executive Director of the Coalition to Abolish Slavery and Trafficking, also known as CAST.
Thank you, Sheriff. Good morning, and thank you all for joining us. I'm the CEO of CAST, Coalition to Abolish Slavery and Trafficking, but also a proud member of this task force that serves as the lead service provider to ensure the safety and the rights of human trafficking survivors. For over 22 years, we've been serving the Los Angeles community with comprehensive care for survivors who are trafficked in industries like commercial sex, agriculture, hospitality, domestic work, factories, begging, and what is commonly called forced criminality. Our model is advancing best practices through an evidence-driven approach. This means that we learn from survivors, and what they tell us is that trust matters. In an ongoing case, a survivor we identified with our task force partners felt safe enough to lead to her encouraging other survivors from the same case to come forward to also receive services, which then resulted in reporting the crime. By speaking her language, understanding her culture, and putting her needs first, that is what trust looks like. As a task force, we are continuing to find these cutting-edge approaches to serving survivors that prioritizes their human rights, secures their safety, and provides access to services while holding traffickers accountable. I want to thank all of these amazing community leaders up here with me today for being stewards of our shared community values to address both labor and sex trafficking in our region. Our experience has taught us that there is no simple solution to ending human trafficking, and that if we really want to address it head on, the county, the city, and the state must invest resources that brings together multiple agencies like this, working to engage our community. Our county, our city, our state must invest in data and research to fully understand the prevalence here and across our state. We should embrace survivors' rights and provide easy access to services to survivors of both sex and labor trafficking. We should shift our coordinated efforts to be inclusive of a public health approach, especially in this current climate of fear, to address the vulnerabilities of people at risk for trafficking, increase early identification and prevention. And finally, California must strengthen our regulations and enforcement of businesses to better prevent human trafficking, such as enacting legislation that focuses on common exploitation practices in the workplace and protecting vulnerable immigrant communities and low-wage workers. I am thrilled to announce that the City of Los Angeles, under the leadership of President Nury Martinez, is the first local government to take action on sponsored legislation by CAST, SB 630, just last week. Los Angeles, as a region, is actively engaging our business community to be a part of the solution by posting information, a 24-hour hotline, that will give survivors access to safety and services. We call on the Los Angeles County to take similar action. So you see, the coordinated steps that we take as a community before you today will have a deeper impact here at home, but also a global impact given California's economic significance and leadership in the world. Thank you for your kind attention.
A los noticieros en español. Cada enero se lleva a cabo una fuerza de tarea conjunta de el Departamento de Alguacil del Condado de Los Ángeles, Departamento de Policía, y estamos operando en coordinación con otras fuerzas de tarea conjunta a través de todo el estado de California y con otros departamentos de alguacil y de departamentos de policía y proveedores de servicios para víctimas a través de todo el estado de California. Las personas que aquí que están presentes son una representación de todo el esfuerzo que se llevó a cabo a través de todo el estado de California. Y eso pasó entre el 26 de enero y el 1 de febrero de este mes. Y a razón de este esfuerzo, se llevaron a cabo 76 adultos que fueron rescatados, 11 menores de edad que fueron rescatados, 27 sospechosos de tráfico humano y explotadores fueron arrestados y 266 clientes de prostitución también fueron arrestados. En un total de 518 arrestos criminales se condujeron a razón de esta semana de operación. Y fueron muchos cuentos a través de todo, historias de todo el estado de gente que fueron rescatados exitosamente, y un caso en particular de Santa Clara, donde un abusador, explotador o traficador humano tenía a tres víctimas trabajando para él, y las tres víctimas eran adictos a la heroína, y él mantenía en su posesión no solamente la heroína, sino el Narcan, que es el antídoto de la heroína para contrarrestar los efectos, para mantenerlos vivos, para seguirlos explotando. Y esa es la seriedad de este caso en particular. Pero queremos dejarle un mensaje a todos los traficadores humanos. No se va a permitir nunca. Estamos esperando, los vamos a buscar, encontrar y arrestar. Y a los que son víctimas del tráfico humano, los vamos a rescatar y vamos a darle la oportunidad que viva una vida mejor, libre del abuso, de la explotación de los traficadores humanos. Any questions, English or Spanish, for anyone here?
Could you give some LA examples of the operations?
Actually, we had two in particular. We had one out of our department, and that was, we had one from us, and we had one from LAPD. Van Nuys division. They were in particular, and they were the results of stings, reverse stings. And one was, I think the Van Nuys LAPD one was an ad, a commercial website that features sex trafficking. And the person appeared to be a minor. And they followed up on the ad and got a hold of the person. They observed a commercial sex ad depicting who they believed to be a 16 or 17-year-old female on a known commercial sex website. The detectives communicated with the female, arranged to meet her in her hotel room. During their surveillance of the motel, they noticed a male watching the room closely. Detectives detained the female in the room and the male in the car. Inside the car with the male was a 2-year-old child of the female. The child was taken into protective custody and released into the care of the Department of Children and Family Services, DCFS. The female was released and referred to victim service provider, which was Journey Out. I think we have a Journey Out representative
here. Right here.
There we do.
Yep.
And the male was identified as a member of a local street gang and arrested for human trafficking. And additionally, a loaded 9mm handgun was found in the hotel room. So part of this this whole operation, it can be very perilous, as you can tell. Este caso de la policía de Los Ángeles, en la red social había un comercial donde los policías del LAPD percataron que la persona parecía que era menor de edad. Y ellos, mediante la solicitación, llegaron a un hotel donde esperaban encontrar a la persona en el comercial. Y la detuvieron y detuvieron una persona, un pandillero local que estaba mirando y observando la interacción entre la policía y la víctima. Y ese pandillero tenía en su posesión un niño de 2 años que era el hijo de la víctima de tráfico humano. Y el señor también estaba armado con una pistola de 9mm. Ese es... muestra sencillamente el peligro que tiene todo el mundo con el tráfico humano, porque las personas que son los sospechosos no son gente buena. Armados, poseyendo drogas, usando drogas para mantener sujetos a los víctimas, es algo muy feo. Another case, detectives from the LA Regional Human Trafficking Task Force arrested a 52-year-old man for arranging to have sex with a minor. The man began communicating with undercover detectives on a social media application. During the chat conversation, detectives told the male multiple times they were 16 years old. The male continued to communicate with who he believed to be a minor, ultimately arranging to meet for sex. Upon his arrival at a local hotel, the male was arrested. That's another example of so many different ways that this task force across the state is doing. Then we do reverse sting operations where we have decoys working and posing as sex workers, and then that's how you have a lot of the stings where a lot of the Johns are arrested as well, and that happened throughout this week. And you see the stats for the whole time. It'll give you an idea of the scope of it. Those are statewide statistics, and that's just 1 week. And we should bear in mind that's just 1 week, but this is 24/7, 365, all year long, all day long, all night long. The sex industry continues going on and continues exploiting defenseless people. So we're here to rescue them.
Deputy Chief Chris Pitcher from LAPD has got some success stories he'd like to read a couple.
Yes. Deputy Chief?
Hey.
Please.
Good morning. I'm Deputy Chief Chris Pitcher. I am the Chief of Detectives for the Los Angeles Police Department. And we're often asked, subsequent to major task forces like this, but like Sheriff Villanueva said, essentially, this goes on 365 days a year. There are literally thousands of these arrests made in LA by the LA County Sheriffs and the LAPD. But what I want to share with you is the result of some of these cases. And I'm going to read 4 quick things that is the result of an effective partnership, a partnership between the LAPD, the LA County Sheriff's Department, the Department of Children and Family Services, our governmental resource providers, Journey Out, Saving Grace, and ultimately others that they give to us to provide these services in these issues. But the DA, Jackie Lacey, has her unit that comes out and deals with these effective prosecutions. I want to share 4 cases that occurred in the LA region last year and what happened to them. In one instance, a 16-year-old female was sexually assaulted, savagely beaten, and sustained severe head injuries by her 30-year-old trafficker in order to make her work as a commercial sex worker. After a lengthy trial, the suspect was convicted of assault with a deadly weapon, rape, human trafficking of a minor, and he received a life sentence. And this was just last year. Another instance, a 25-year-old trafficker regularly beat a 15-year-old female and a 19-year-old female in order to have them continue to work in the commercial sex industry. The suspect was convicted of assault with a deadly weapon, rape, sodomy, human trafficking of a minor, and he received a 29-year sentence, and he is now a lifetime 296 registrant. The third example, a 16-year-old mentally disabled female was forced to work as a commercial sex worker by three suspects. She was enforced to ingest alcohol and narcotics and was then viciously sexually assaulted by one of the suspects over a three-hour period and forced to work in the commercial sex industry. All suspects were found guilty during a jury trial and convicted of rape by force and human trafficking of a minor. Two of the suspects received life sentences as the result of this investigation. And the last instance that I want to bring to your attention is a 16-year-old female, and all these happened in 19, disclosed that a 30-year-old male had forced her to work as a commercial sex worker. The suspect physically beat her when she tried to escape from him on numerous occasions. The suspect was convicted of human trafficking of a minor, and he just received a 31-year-to-life sentence for his aggravated crimes. These are the results of the cases that come out of these human trafficking task force operations and the daily operations by law enforcement agencies up and down the state of California. And then when we get these sentences, we work very effectively once again with the DA's offices in providing their sex trafficking units and all of their expertise. And then we have great non-governmental resource providers coming alongside to lift these people out of those issues, provide them life-saving skills, life-rebuilding skills, and ultimately, like Zoe, and saving innocence, and ultimately, journey out, working with us hand in glove every day to reclaim these victims and to turn their lives back around and to prosecute those vicious criminals who prey upon them. So thank you very much. I appreciate giving me the opportunity to give you the examples of exactly what happens to these cases throughout the remaining months when they get prosecuted.
Thank you, Chief. That definitely gives you the long view of these cases. And this is from this 1 week worth of enforcement effort, then that's going to play out over the next several months as these cases get prosecuted as well. So as you can tell, it's a very sophisticated operation. It takes a lot of hard work from our part, and all we're doing is trying to push back against the sophisticated criminal operation that's happening on the other side of the coin. So there's a lot of work to do. So again, thank you all. Thank you everyone for participating, every role that you played in this, and let's keep doing it. Thank you. ¿Alguna pregunta en español? Desafortunadamente, las redes sociales contribuyen a la explotación de los menores y las víctimas de tráfico humano, porque antes de la existencia de las redes sociales, todo este tráfico se llevaba a cabo a la luz pública, a la luz del día, y se podía observar, y entonces podíamos interceptar muchas veces, pero ahora ocurre todo detrás de las puertas, afuera de la luz pública, en lugares privados, y es mucho más fácil la comunicación entre el sospechoso, las víctimas, o los sospechosos solicitando más víctimas. Y los inocentes sin saber con quién están hablando, por eso es las redes sociales lo hacen más difícil a nosotros.
¿Y qué tan vulnerable es la comunidad inmigrante?
Muy vulnerable, porque la comunidad inmigrante por sí temen acudir a los oficiales públicos, a la policía, a los alguaciles, por temor que nosotros estamos involucrados en enforzar las leyes inmigratorias y no los estamos haciendo. Hay cero tolerancia de cooperar con las leyes federales o los la policía, ¿cómo decir? Los federales, inmigración, ICE. No estamos envueltos en eso en ningún momento. Queremos dejar entender a toda la comunidad inmigrante que estamos aquí para servirlos y no para arrestarlos para alguna cosa de inmigración. Y pueden acudir a la policía local, ya sea LAPD, Sheriff's Department o cualquier agencia local. Aquí está Anaheim PD, aquí está San Bernardino County Sheriff. Todas las agencias locales no están usando sus recursos para leyes de inmigración.
¿Cuántas víctimas y cuántos sospechosos fueron arrestados?
Fueron 76 víctimas adultos que fueron rescatados, 11 menores de edad rescatados, y se llevaron a cabo 518 arrestos. En total. Okay. All right, thank you.
Thank you, Sheriff.
Okay.